women, you know, her father, your sisters and aunts and your mothers, we're human beings also. And every human being deserves to be treated like a human being. The 8th Amendment of the United States Constitution gives us the right against cruel and unusual punishment.
Today I'm going to be doing a demonstration for y'all, showing y'all what they call strip cell in the Alabama prison system. This is part of the solitary confinement aspect of punishment, really. And it's cruel and unusual. And we make these statements not lightly, but in respect and regard for the civil and human rights of all people in this country. And what we're demonstrating already around the nation is that the 13th Amendment to the United States Constitution clearly states that neither slavery nor involuntary servitude except as punishment for crime where the party shall have been duly convicted shall exist in the United States is a reality that goes beyond just the words of the 13th Amendment. And it actually incorporates the very same practices that were incorporated in 1865 when the institution of slavery, the enterprise of slavery, was nationalized. And by that I mean that private citizens were restricted from continuing ownership of human beings as property. But the 13th Amendment said that there was an exception for people who are accept as punishment for crime. And the state and the federal government are the institutions that carry out punishment for crime. And so therefore, it is the institution of slavery that became state controlled. It was a nationalized enterprise then. At that time, they began to mass incarcerate African Americans. They began to pass laws like vagrancy laws and the black codes, which were then used to justify the mass incarceration of the newly freed we were only partially free or temporarily free or conditionally free. A lot of the slave masters became wardens, correctional officers, police officers, judges, prosecutors, and they all became part of this system to reincarcerate. And the way that they would create a salary, make a living, but not all of them understood that with the 13th Amendment, depriving them of the right as private citizens to own slaves, that they could then become a part of the system that was created under the 13th Amendment, which was as punishment for crime. And so they became the agents to determine what a duly convicted person was. They became the jury. So you can imagine what it was to be accused of a crime, an 1865 justice system that is nothing but about the continuation and perpetuation of slavery. And so we're exposing the conditions of confinement today, 2016, that continues this practice. And so that's what I'll be doing today with the solitary confinement, showing you how solitary confinement works, how it was used then, how it has evolved over the last three centuries or so to what we have today in America, and particularly in Alabama, which is the harshest prison system in the nation.
Two and a half, 250 years or so, that could sell all of your personal properties taken. You don't have a toothbrush. You don't have toothpaste. You don't have yogurt. You don't have soap. You don't have any clothes. You're stripped down literally to nothing. You put in underwear and everything else is taken from you, except for your shop. For any reason or for no reason, any supervisor can authorize it. There is not really a protocol for it. And as you all know, in Alabama, there's not a grievance procedure, so there's no way that we can even complain about it. And so this is how you live in a strip cell. And I know you're wondering, what do you do about a mattress? Well, if you don't get a mattress, you sleep on this concrete slab. This is what you sleep on. You might be on it for a week. Some people have been on it for a month. You know, and some people even longer. But however long you're in a strip cell, these will be just where you sleep at. For however many days that you're on a strip cell. And so, this is what you have. As I told you, you strip down everything, and you put in isolation, and you put in a cell for 3 days, a week, a month. I know people that have been on for all the months in a strip cell. This is what you sleep on.
Give me second class houses.
Just like this.
While you're watching this, just think about the damage that sleeping on a concrete slab for multiple days back to back does to your lower back, your spine, your neck, your shoulders, circulation, your arteries throughout the body. This is just pure torture. It's unright, it's unconstitutional, it's inhumane. Nevertheless, this is something that goes on every day inside the Alabama Department of Corrections.
And it's full of folks like me who are black, yellow, beige, and brown. It's the backlash. I'm gonna leave you with a backlash.
Strip cell in the Alabama Department of Corrections. This is part of the policy. This is just another one of the practices that has been transplanted from the slave plantation directly to the prison system as authorized by the 13th Amendment to the United States Constitution.
My wages and send my son to Vietnam. You give me second class houses.
The fact that, you know, you were pardoning us for even having to have a dialogue of this nature. That when the freedom is on the line, your life is on the line, that, you know, we have to be asked whether or not we in or we out. You know, are we with it or we not? What are we gonna do?